fasting was losing its focus. In both the readings today, at the time of Prophet Isaiah and at the time of Jesus, this fasting was considered just to be a mandate. Just do it. It's an action just to be done. And this is where Isaiah confronts that present generation with these words of God saying that you don't do fasting for your own interest. You don't do it to oppress others around you. You don't do it to strike others and fight with others. In different words, you don't do this action at all cost and at the cost of others. Rather, you do it not to oppress, but to let the oppressed go free, to lift up the difficulties of others, to share your bread with the hungry, to feed and clothe those who are unfortunate. So in different words, it is an act done to realign ourselves. We realign so that we are brought back from going off track. If our human craving, if our human desires have led us off track, it is to bring us once again closer to God and closer to one another. So it brings you into that realm of God and that realm of relationship. Fasting, though may physically make us weak, mentally and emotionally, it can really build you strong. It's one of the ways you can overpower your human craving and stick to your heart and what your rational mind has worked on. So something what remains only in theory, with your constant effort to overpower your body, to overpower your human desire, even of that food, which is the basic necessity, is being overpowered by your mind and by your heart. So it is a type of a sacrifice. An inner sacrifice, the spirit which is must. You can't do an action without losing that spirit. So this is a type of a sacrifice which you are making for a purpose, for something, for someone, or to build up something in you. It's not just a simple mandatory act, a mandate that is being carried on once again, as I said, just for the sake of doing, just because you have to do it, and even at the cost of others. Even making a terrible situation or horrible situation for you and those living around you. But rather, it should bring in that God in your life and in the lives of others. It should bring you once again back to that original image of human person. That original image that God has created you to be. And see that image in others too. Let us pray in all the different fasts that we take up, that we may build a better world around us. We may bring in more of that God and goodness in our lives with different acts of fasting, and not just do it for the sake of doing, not just do it as a mandatory act or just a mandate that our religion, our faith, or some of our habits of the past asks of us.